Were you ever taught when you were young? If you mess with things selfishly, they're bound to come undone. I'm not the only one that's been affected and resented every story you've spun, and I'm a lucky one.
That was Demi Lovato with Commander in Chief. Welcome to the Rise Weekly Review for October 26th through November 2nd, 2020. Our top story from last week is an update from a story we reported the previous week about a shooting in East Chicago, Indiana. 8-year-old Tamia Andrews was sitting in her home doing her homework on October 22nd when a stray bullet struck her. The shot came from an automatic weapon that was fired near the home on 4522 Magoon Avenue just after 10 p.m. The child struggled for her life in Comer's Children's Hospital throughout the week, but sadly on Wednesday the 28th, she passed away. A reward of $10,000 is being offered to anyone with information that can lead to an arrest. Anyone with information is asked to contact the East Chicago Police at 219-391-8500. A man was shot and killed on 68th and Paxton in South Shore on Saturday. The man had stepped outside his home around 8:25 p.m. when two people walked up to him and began firing shots. The man was struck multiple times in the body. He was taken to the University of Chicago Medical Center where he was pronounced dead. On Wednesday the 28th, a 28-year-old man was wounded from a shooting on 105th and Avenue E in the East Side neighborhood. Around 1:20 a.m., the man was exiting his vehicle when someone in a sedan drove up and began firing shots. The man was struck in his face and left hand. He was taken to the University of Chicago Medical Center and last reported in good condition. An attempted carjacking in South Shore on Saturday resulted in a shooting in South Chicago. Around 1:30 p.m., a group of men apparently tried carjacking another man around 77th and Bennett. One man apparently got out of the car and tried jacking the man, but was chased off. The 32-year-old victim then chased the carjackers to South Chicago around 88th and Colfax, where he began opening fire. The vehicle was hit multiple times, however, nobody was injured, and nobody was reported as being arrested. A similar incident in Munster, Indiana on Thursday resulted in the arrest of two men. Around 5:37 p.m. on Thursday, the 29th, two men held up a woman at gunpoint at a BP gas station located on 747 Ridge Road. The men stole her white Durango and fled north on Calumet Avenue. The Illinois State Police followed the car with a helicopter as the vehicle was pursued by Munster, Indiana police. The driver crashed the vehicle into a ditch on Kennedy Avenue, and both men tried to escape on foot, where they were eventually captured by police. The suspects were only identified as a 22-year-old man from Calumet City and a 17-year-old man from Linwood. A mural has been completed by four local artists in South Chicago. The mural was placed on the building at 3101 East 92nd Street. It was completed by artists Anna Murphy, Grigor Eftimov, Jesse Navetta, and Jasmina Kasaku. Each artist added a portion of the mural representing one of the four elements of earth, wind, water, and fire. Other artwork is also springing up around South Chicago, including new neighborhood markers installed near 92nd and Commercial Avenue. Before ending, we would also like to remind the community that Tuesday the 3rd is Election Day. Please make sure to vote and let your voice be heard. You can find a list of local election sites on the Chicago Board of Elections website. You can also join us on our live stream that will cover the local election and happenings around the nation and Chicago. Finally, the Rise community would like to extend our congratulations to George Washington High School student Emily Perez for qualifying for the Illinois High School Association State Sectionals in cross country for the fourth time in 4 years. Congratulations to Emily Perez. You make the whole community proud. Thank you all very much for joining us for this week in review.